Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. Here we'll take a look how to use ValueNotifier. Instead of using ChangeNotifier Provider, we'll use ValueNotifier. Well, previously we built this app using ChangeNotifier Provider, and here we created a class, and in the class we extend ChangeNotifier, and we created a variable and a method, and at the same time we have assigned notify listeners so that our widgets on this main.dart file gets notified once we make changes. So here we have injected our provider using ChangeNotifier provider, and then we use this consumer widget to listen to the changes. At the same time, because we have injected our provider, so we were able to call certain methods and increase the value. Well, here we'll see, instead of using ChangeNotifier provider, we'll see how to use ValueNotifier, and it's pretty easy. Well, first we'll use, over here, we'll use ValueNotifier instead of ChangeNotifier. Okay, and then it'll get us some error. It says that we must create constructor to call super. All right, now over here, we need to remove these values. We don't need them anymore because value notifier basically works with one value. So the value you could pass, or it could be optional. Okay, but we'll pass a value to it, and that value we'd grab it over here. So the place where we call this value notifier, which means this one, from there we'll pass a value. The value would be passed to the super constructor, and as well as injected in this class. So we'll simply create a new method, and here we'll call so this is the method that we want to call as we click on the button. So with this, we are done with the setup of our value notifier. Now over here, as you see with the ChangeNotifier provider, it's much more complicated. You have to have a provider, and you have to pass the certain provider type, then you have to create a constant, and then you have to inject it with the child as well. But with ValueNotifier, we don't need any of this thing. So all we need, we'll keep this material app, and the rest of this we'll delete. We don't need this thing. So with ValueNotifier, this section gets much more cleaner, right? Okay. Now over here, of course, we won't be able to use this one. Now inside this build method, we have to get our dependencies. So this is our dependencies. So we have to inject it. So here we'll do it, and here we'll call, create an instance of it, and we'll call it counter. And we create instance using this provider, my provider controller. But here we need to pass a value, as you can see. So it's expecting an argument. So here we passed one, right? So here we'll simply pass an int value. Okay, all right. So now we are passing this value, and over here we'd be able to increase the value. Of course, you can mention the type explicitly, what kind of values you are passing. So previously we used consumer for ChangeNotifier provider, but in this case we don't need anything like this. So, but we'll still keep this builder. So instead of consumer, over here we'll use value listenable builder. Okay, value listenable builder. Now this works with, once you extend value notifier. So here we need this one. So here we need a required argument, okay, which is value listenable. Now this one wants an instance of the injected controller or the notifier, which is this one. So pass it this one over here simply. Okay, now inside this text, we don't need this like this. So here we'll just simply remove this section, we don't need this anymore. And here we'll just keep this one, my provider. So my provider will refer to the value over here, this one, okay? All right, so that's how you change a consumer widget to value listenable builder. Now, once again, this directly works with this value notifier. So that's how you change it. Now, over here, it's pretty much the same. So instead of reading this context like this, you'll remove that one and you will use this instance, the one you created early. Okay, and you can similarly call this method, but of course we change the method name, so we'll call it value increment. Okay, so we'll just put it here and the error is gone. So that's how you convert change notifier provider to value notifier. Now we'll run our app, okay, and we'll tap on this and we see that it works. Okay, so personally I think value notifier is much more easier to use than change notifier provider. And if you learn something, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Thank you so much.